Students participated in a 3-week study abroad program in Costa Rica, hosted by Cartier and Torrealba, an international institute that aims to increase sustainable management of agriculture and conservation of natural resources, as well as enhance human well-being in Latin America and the Caribbean. Students from Delaware State University were joined by Tuskegee University and Alabama A&M University. This international experience was meant to provide students and faculty with a deeper understanding of the global aspect of crop production and agronomics, while also exposing participants to Costa Rican language and culture. During class lectures, we engaged in discussions inside and outside of the classroom. Professor Guillermo introduced the different types of agroforestry systems and how they are used with agriculture in Costa Rica.
We have this woodlot here. This is a Melina arborea woodlot. This is a plantation of 4 years old. And you see the tree without leaves, yeah?
Yeah.
So the ants are working.
Okay.
During our stay with Cartier, we visited local farms and a variety of examples that included sustainable practices and also exposed us to the culture and life in Costa Rica. We were able to see how different agroforestry systems were used in one of Cartier's own coffee plantations.
We were able to visit an organic farm, which proved to be a profound example of Costa Rica's family farming and sustainable community agriculture. Owned and operated by Don Jose and his family, Finca Cañaveral is a 10-hectare farm that mainly produces organic sugarcane, further processed sugarcane products, and a small amount of coffee, which they sell to the community as well as visitors. Here we have a step in the processing of coffee in which Don Jose uses the sun as a resource for drying the beans. Then we visited Cartier's germplasm bank, where they preserve 5 main seed families in a negative 20 degrees Celsius cold storage. The grafting method was presented to us as a means for cocoa tree propagation. It is a process in which one bud is affixed to an exposed part of an existing plant and then severed 2 weeks later. One skilled worker can complete upwards of 350 to 400 grafts per day. We visited a small-scale farm in Santa Cruz run by Don Roger and his 2 brothers. Along with cilantro, lettuce, and celery, they produce organically grown strawberries adjacent to a raised hydroponic system. It is another example of family farming. This particular farm serves as a model for sustainability within the Santa Cruz community.
Dr. Eliesa Vargas was our instructor in learning about the cost and benefits of sustainable tourism. The 4 aims of sustainable tourism include biological diversity, resource efficiency, environmental purity, and physical integrity. Throughout the remainder of the trip, all of these practices were seen in different forms of tourism. Our visit to Guayabo Archaeological Monument demonstrated natural resource conservation and promoting community-based tourism. The historical site preserves culture through its excavated ruins and the conservation of its pre-montane rainforest.
So what is that?
When we say community place.
On our trip to Mojajones, we visited the local school and the guayabo farm to learn the technique of layering. This air layering method is a common practice used in plant propagation to bear fruit sooner from the mother plant with the same great taste. Many of the local farms use manual labor to harvest their crops. We were able to see the entire process of how sugar cane is harvested, boiled, filtered and purified to produce the final product for sale.
Show me!
More than a hora.
A few of Cartier's master students that study sustainable tourism joined us in visiting Casa Torrie, a luxury hotel in Torrealba that is certified under Costa Rica Sustainable Tourism Certification for its sustainable practices that benefit tourists as well as the local community. During our last week, we traveled to Cahuita in the South Caribbean of Costa Rica. Our two-day immersion with the indigenous Bribri tribe began with an hour-long canoe ride on the Yorkin River, which separated Panama and Costa Rica. Our two-day visit with the Bribri tribe was a physically, mentally, and culturally rewarding experience.
Our next trip was to Finca Loroco in Talamanca, a small farm run by Gonzalo Ventura. This farm is a producer of macuna, pineapple, garlic, and root vegetables. It is also home to a community seed bank, as Don Gonzalo has deemed himself protector of the seeds. We were able to get an idea of how such an establishment contributes to and benefits the community. Then we traveled to APTA, also known as the Association of Small Producers of Talamanca. This association consists of 932 producers, of which 80% are of indigenous descent and 20% are black and white. They primarily produce bananas and cocoa and have obtained both USDA organic and fair trade certifications. The last leg of the program takes us to Cahuita National Park, one that is maintained and operated solely by the surrounding community, with no government interference. Donations from tourists are the means with which to keep the park running. The park is home to a variety of wildlife, including sloths, monkeys, snakes, and a diverse coral reef.